Good morning, students. Welcome back to your social studies class. Earlier we have discussed about the natural resources and we have studied the different distribution of natural resources. We have discussed about the biotic resources, abiotic resources, then we have discussed about the actual resources and the potential resources. After that we learned about the renewable and non-renewable resources, and the last classification of natural resources were first was localized and second was ubiquitous resources. So now our next topic of this chapter is human made resources. So what are human made resources? Human made resources are the resources which are created by the human with the help of natural resources and after using the technology. As if we want to use the natural resource, we must have, you know, proper information about the technology, because technology is the thing which convert the natural resources into a useful resource so that it can be used for our, you know, for different purposes, for making our life more comfortable, right? So what is human made resource? Human made resources mean the resources developed by a human being using natural resources with the help of technology, right? Earlier coal and petroleum were not considered resources unless when, you know, a human came to know that how we can extract these resources from the surface of earth. So from this we can came to know that these are the natural resources, but the resources information is not to anyone, because nobody knows how we can extract these minerals from the surface of earth. So it means that human resources are the resources which developed by using the natural resources. So if we have knowledge, if we have ability to understand the new inventions and technology, we can make various things from the natural resources so that we can use them for different purposes, right? Then as we know that we construct building, roads and bridges, all these things are made with the help of natural resources. But when we, you know, collectively use human resources as well as natural resources, we came up with the product which is known as human made resources, right? So technology is also a human made resources, because technology is invented by the human to make his life easy. That's why we call technology is also a human made resource. Then we will discuss about that what is human resource. We are talking about human made resource. Human made resource, the things which are created by human. So how human can create all these things? So for creating all these things, human must have skill, must have knowledge. And when we call a human having a skill and knowledge, it become a resource for the country. So human resource means it is a most important resource, because only skillful and knowledgeable human can use the best use of natural resource. This is due to the knowledge and skill of the human that human is able to use the natural resources in different purposes to make his life easy. For example, we have a country which is Japan. It has advanced technology. So what is the reason behind having a very advanced or modern technology? The reason is human resources. They have those type of humans which have lot of skill, they have lot of knowledge. And when a human having lot of skill and lot of knowledge, he can convert the natural resources into different possible or tremendous result, and we call those humans as a human resource, right? So the two things which make an ordinary man a human resource is education and health. With the help of education, an ordinary human can become a human resource for the country. And health also play a very important role. If a human is healthy in nature, then he can, you know, focus on the things that he want to make for making his life more comfortable, right? So this was human made resource, and the other is human resource. Yes, students, now moving on to the last topic of this chapter, which is conservation of resources. as we know that resources are very important for all of us, for our economy, for you know, for the development. So resources very important for socio-economic development of a country. For a country, we call a country a developed country when the country have sufficient resources. The resources can be natural resources and human made resources. So both these resources are required for making a country a developed country. So those areas which have resources, natural as well as human resources, we call those countries developed country. But some countries who are lagging behind, the reason behind their laggingness is the lack of resources. So we call that if a country, if we want to call a country a developed country, the country must have natural resources as well as human made resources. So natural resources and human made resources collectively responsible for socio-economic development of a country. So now moving to the topic, which is conservation of resources. As we know that resources are very important for all of us, so we should protect our resources. We should not waste our resources, because if we waste our resources, then these resources will not be available for the future generation, right? So when we, you know, use the resources in a limited manner, we call it a conservation of resources. So use of resources in limited manners. So when we follow this practice, we are following the practice of conservation of resources. For this activity, we can use sustainable management. So what is sustainable management? Sustainable management means when we use the resources according to our requirement and then left the resources for future use. Like for example, that we have a resource water, and if we, you know, do not avoid the wastage of water, then there will be shortage of water for our future generation. So that is the reason for conserving the resources, because if we will not conserve the resources, then these resources will not be available for the future generation, right? So, you know, different activities can be performed for conserving the resources. For example, first is we should sustainable use of resource, that we should use the resource only to the level we required, and you know, do not waste the resources, because if we waste so much of resources, then these resources will not be available for the future generation. Then the diversity of the life on the earth should be conserved. If we conserve these resources, automatically this will help for the conservation of human resources on the earth. Then to minimize the damage of natural environmental system. As we know that human is using different practices of using natural resources, but we should maintain a balance. If we will not maintain the balance between human resources, human made resources and natural resources, so what will happen? This unbalancing cause effect on our natural environment, right? Like we are cutting the forest for creating industries and for creating factories. So under this, what is going on? Human activities are performed to use the natural resource in a best way, but when we cut the forest in a very large number, what will happen? The level of pollution started increasing. It become very difficult to control the pollution, because trees are the main source of oxygen, and you know, with the help of a trees, the amount of pollution can be controlled. So this is the activities we should perform. Like you have a story in your book which is of Mona. He had a nightmare that she dreamed that all the water on the earth had dried up. So her amma told her that if we will not conserve the water, then this will be the reality of our world, that all the resources of water should dry up. So these students also tried to, you know, conserve the resources. One student told that I will not waste the paper, because for creating the paper we have to cut trees, because paper can be recycled again. So he say that I cannot waste the paper. Other one told that if I will see that electricity is, you know, wasting anywhere, I will switch off the fans, I will switch off the light. So all students should also participate for conserving the resources, because we are the future generation. If we will not conserve the resources, what will happen? The resources will not be available for your use. I hope you understand the chapter of resources, of natural resources as well as human made resources and conserving of resources. Thank you, students, and have a nice day.